Yes, Siva sir, I have started.
Okay, sir.
So from this P2, we will get P1, that is lower pressure, into P4, that is higher pressure. So lots of problem we have done related to this thing. Today also one more problem we will do related to this one. But before that, first I will complete this one. What is the difference between fan, blower and compressor? So this thing they are asking normally 2 marks or 3 marks questions. What is the difference between fan, blower and compressor? So this thing we will complete it, and after that we will solve one more last problem related to this reciprocating compressor, and we will complete unit 3 today itself. So today we are going to start with comparison between fan, blower and compressor. So one by one we will discuss what is the difference between fan, blower and compressor. So first we will start with compressor. So already you know what is a compressor. Already I have told you. So compressor, first point, compressor is a mechanical device that increases the pressure of a fluid by reducing its volume. So this thing already I have explained, because we know ideal gas equation is PV equal to MRT. Okay. So if mass of the fluid, universal gas constant and temperature of air is constant, then this P should be inversely proportional to volume. Means if we can decrease the volume, we can increase the pressure. Okay. So based upon this one, the compressor will work. The compressor is a mechanical device that increases the pressure of a fluid by reducing its volume. Okay. So by reducing the volume of the fluid, by compressing the fluid, it will increase the pressure of the fluid. The second point, the inlet diameter of the pipe will be more than the outlet diameter. This reduces the volume flow rate and thus the pressure of the fluid increases. So normally, so you can see in this air compressor, here we are using a cylinder to compress the air, because we are talking regarding the fluid. What do you mean by fluid? Fluid means anything that can flow. Okay. Fluid is anything which can flow. So this fluid can be air. This fluid can be water also. It can be air, it can be water. So to compress this air, we need this arrangement. Thus this cylinder should be there. Okay. But how to compress the water? Okay. So for this one, what we are doing? We are doing one arrangement where the inlet diameter of the pipe will be more than the outlet diameter. So like this one pipe we are using. Okay. So like this one pipe we will use, and through this pipe we will flow the fluid. The fluid will flow. This can be useful for water also. Yeah, sorry, this can be useful for air also. Okay. So this is the inlet part. This is the entrance part, or outlet part, or entrance part, whatever you can say. Not outlet part. Let me see. This is the inlet part. This you can say outlet part. And the fluid will flow like this. The fluid can flow in this direction. So here what we can say, the inlet diameter of the fluid will be more than the outlet diameter of the fluid. So in this case, what will happen? This reduces the volume flow rate and thus the pressure of the fluid will increase. Because how the pressure will increase? If we can decrease the volume, then the pressure will increase. So here you see the inlet diameter. This is the inlet diameter and this is the outlet diameter. So you can see inlet diameter is more than outlet diameter. So at the outlet, the diameter is gradually decreasing. If diameter will decrease, then volume flow rate will also decrease. Because what is volume flow rate? Volume flow rate is pi by 4 p square L into n by 6. Okay. So if this diameter will less, then accordingly this volume will also decrease. And if volume will decrease, then pressure will increase. And if pressure will increase, we can say that it is a compressor. Okay. So we can increase the pressure by using this cylinder piston arrangement. In the cylinder piston arrangement, what will happen? The piston will compress the air, or else we can use this kind of pipe also. But the difference is, in the cylinder piston arrangement, we can only compress the air. We cannot compress the water. But here, by arranging this pipe arrangement, we can compress any kind of fluid. We can compress air, we can compress water also. So depending upon the application, we will use either this pipe or this cylinder to compress the air. Okay. So various types of air compressor are there. Rotary compressor, this regarding this reciprocating compressor, this is an example of reciprocating compressor. In unit 3, we have studied regarding reciprocating compressor. In unit 4, in the next unit, we are going to study regarding centrifugal compressor and axial compressor. So quickly, I will show you all these things in the syllabus copy. So here you can see, okay, it is not there here. I will share the syllabus copy with you. In the syllabus copy, in unit 3, we have this centrifugal compressor. Sorry, in unit 3, we have this reciprocating compressor. We have already studied. And in unit 4, I mean in our last unit, we are going to study regarding rotary compressor, centrifugal compressor, and axial flow compressor. Okay. This is regarding compressor. Next thing is fan. Already you know what you mean by fan. Okay, so fan is a machine which is used to create a fluid flow. So this is an example of fan. In your house also, you might have using this fan. What basically it is doing? It will increase the velocity of the air. It will increase the velocity of the air. Okay. The difference between compressor, this compressor will increase the pressure of the air. It will increase the pressure. What happens to the fan? The fan will increase the velocity flow of air. Okay. So fan is a machine which is used to create fluid flow. The flow of the fluid is increased with the fan. It produces high volume and low pressure than the ambient condition. So what it will happen? It will do exactly the opposite thing of compressor. In compressor, what we are doing? We are decreasing the volume so that we can increase the pressure. But in fan, what we are doing? We are expanding the air. Means we are increasing its volume. And if we will increase the volume, then significantly its pressure will decrease. Okay. And if pressure will decrease, then we can increase the velocity of air. Okay. So lots of applications are there. It is mainly used as a cooling device. Already you know this fan we are using as a cooling device in computer CPUs. Okay. So in the CPU of the computer, you are having the phone, some electronic gadgets. Okay. In all these things, we are using these fans. The main difference between fan and blower, regarding this blower, in the next slide, we are going to study. This is a blower. Okay. So the main difference between fan and blower is, blower can achieve more pressure ratio than fan. Blowers can produce high pressurized air than fan. That is the only difference between fan and blower. Okay. Whatever the work fan will do, exactly the same work we will get in the blower. Okay, but the only difference is in blower, we can increase, we can maintain the pressure of the air little bit higher as compared to fan. So this is an example of the blower. It is there in our workshop also. When you will come in our heat transfer lab, this blower is there. I will show you. The blower will increase the velocity of the air. Okay, the fan will also increase the velocity, and the blower will also increase the velocity of the air when it is passed into the impellers. Okay, so this is the impeller. So when the air will pass through this impeller, it will increase the velocity of air. The inlet pressure will be low and the outlet pressure will be high as compared to fan. At constant volume flow rate, the low pressure air becomes high pressure at the outlet. Okay? At the inlet, the pressure of the air will be a little bit less, but at the outlet, the pressure will be a little bit higher. It is slight, that's why it is slightly different than fan. Okay, what exactly happens in fan? Fan will increase the fluid flow. It will increase the fluid velocity. Blower will also increase the velocity of the air. But the difference between fan and blower is, in blower, we can maintain little bit high pressure as compared to fan. That's what I have written here. Last point. The main difference between fan and blower is, blower can achieve more pressure ratio than the fan. Okay. So here, if you require high pressure with high velocity of air, then we can go for blower. So here we are getting high velocity and high pressure. From blower, we can get high velocity as well as high pressure. What happens in fan? In fan, we are getting high velocity. You try to understand the difference, but we are getting low pressure. Okay. And in compressor, what we are getting? High pressure, low velocity, and high pressure. So depending upon your application, we can use compressor, fan, and blower. Okay, this is the basic difference. In compressor, velocity of the air will be low, but pressure will be exceedingly high. Whatever the pressure you want, that high pressure you can maintain. In fan, velocity will be higher, but pressure will be less. We cannot increase the pressure because just we are expanding the air. And if you will expand the air, its pressure will decrease with the increase of its velocity. And in blower, what we are doing? We are increasing the velocity and we are getting the high pressure also. Not exactly high pressure. Here we can say some intermediate pressure we will get. Intermediate pressure. Intermediate pressure means the pressure which we are getting in blower, it will be more than compressor. Sorry, it will be more than fan and less than compressor. Whatever the pressure value we will get in blower, that pressure will be more than fan pressure, but it will be less than compressor pressure. Okay. So if you want high pressure and low velocity, you go for compressor. If you want high velocity and low pressure, you go for fan. If you want high velocity and intermediate pressure, then you go for blower. Okay, this diagram you do not have to draw in the exam. Okay, just 2-3 points related to fan, blower, and compressor you write and you will get the marks. Okay, so 2-3 marks question they are asking. Explain the difference between fan, blower, and compressor. So that's why I have discussed all these things. If this question they will ask in the exam, just 2-3 points you should write from each part. And you will get the full marks. So let me show you the question, whatever the question they have asked in the previous year related to this thing. Then we will solve one more problem.
అదే పాలకూర ఏముంది పాల
నాట్ గెటింగ్ ద క్వశ్చన్ వేర్ ఇట్ ఇస్ లెట్ మీ ఫైండ్ ఇట్ అవుట్ ఆల్సో I am not getting it. Okay, anyway. So normally 2 or 3 marks question they will ask regarding the difference between this fan blower and compressor. No need to draw this diagram. Just keep the heading and 2-3 points related to this fan blower and compressor. You just mention. Right. So now one more last problem we will do from this unit. And we will complete it. So last class, I have told you, if you have remembered, that today we will do one problem where the intercooling is not perfect. Like here, in this case, you can see the intercooling is not perfect. Okay. So whatever the problems we have done till our last class, in those problems, we have taken perfect intercooling, and we are getting our answer. Okay. But if in exam they will ask this kind of question, mostly they will not ask, but we should prepare that if they will ask this kind of question like intercooling is not perfect, then in that case how to solve the question. So you be ready with calculator. Quickly we are going to do it. Given a 2-stage reciprocating air compressor. So since it is a 2-stage reciprocating air compressor, so first we will draw the pressure versus volume diagram. This is pressure axis. This is volume axis. This is 0.0 to 1. This is the suction process. 1 to 2, this is the compression in first stage. Then 2 to 3, it is the intercooler. 3 to 4, 4 to 5. So this is the lower pressure, suppose it is P1. This is the intermediate pressure, suppose P2. And this is the highest pressure, suppose P. Okay, so this is the first stage of compression. This is the second stage of compression. So what happened? What is given? A two-stage reciprocating air compressor takes in air at 1 bar and 27 degrees Celsius. So air will enter the compressor at 1 bar and 27 degrees Celsius. So pressure P1 equal to 1 bar and temperature P1 is equal to 27 degrees Celsius. This temperature we have to convert into Kelvin. So plus 273 we will do it. So 27 plus 273 we will get 300 Kelvin. And 1 bar we have to convert in kilopascal. So if you want to convert 1 bar into kilopascal, we have to multiply 100, because 1 bar is 100 kilopascal. So total 1 into 100, 100 kilopascal we will get here. Air is delivered at 100 bar, air is delivered at 10 bar. Okay, so delivered at 10 bar means the final pressure of air is given 10 bar. So final pressure means our highest pressure is P4. So P4 is equal to 10 bar. Again, we have to convert this into kilopascal. So 1 bar is 100 kilopascal. So we will get 1000 kilopascal. The intercooling is not perfect. So here the intercooling is not perfect. So polytropic index is given 1.3. Polytropic index means N equal to 1.3. Rate of discharge is 0.1 kg per second. Kg is the unit of mass. Kg per second means mass flow rate. So mass flow rate of air is how much? 0.1 kg per second. And what we have to calculate? We have to calculate the power required to drive the compressor. So the power required to drive the compressor, that is the first point we have to calculate. And second point, what is the second point we have to calculate? Saving of work as compared to single stage compressor. Thus, this same problem already I have done for perfect intercooling. Okay, just so little bit changes I have done in the question paper. I have added this not perfect. Okay, the same problem we have done 2-3 days back. So, but in that problem, we have taken it as a perfect intercooling. But here, what we will do, we will solve this problem with imperfect intercooling. And second work is, we have to calculate the saving work. As compared to single stage compressor, how much work we can save, that we have to calculate in the second point. Assume the intermediate pressure is 3.5 bar. So if it is a not perfect intercooling, then this intermediate pressure also they will mention. So intermediate pressure means P2. This is the intermediate pressure, that is P2. So P2 is how much it is given? P2 is given 3.5 bar. So this 3.5 bar we have to convert into kilopascal. So 3.5 into 100. So this will be equal to 350 kilopascal. Okay. The lowest temperature is 100 kilopascal. Highest temperature is 1000 kilopascal. And intermediate temperature we have 350 kilopascal. Okay, so this much things was given, and the power and saving work we have to calculate. So first we will start with the first point. The first point is power required to drive the compressor. First point that we are going to calculate is power required to drive the compressor. This is the first point that we have to calculate. Right? Okay. So here what we will do, we cannot apply this formula. So power required, which is equal to work input, which is equal to, since it is a two-stage reciprocating compressor, 2 divided by n by n minus 1, mr p1, p2 by p1 whole to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1. This formula we cannot apply here. Why? Because this formula will be applicable for perfect intercooling. If the intercooling is perfect, then only we can apply this formula. But in this question, you can see the intercooling is not perfect. Okay. They have mentioned that the intercooling is not perfect. And here one more thing also, I think I have missed here. This T3 temperature also they have given. Let me check. Yes, this T3 temperature also they have given. This T3 temperature is 40 degrees Celsius. So I forgot to mention here in the question. So T3 temperature was given. T3 means the outlet temperature of intercooler. Here they have, means I forgot to write the line. Here one more line was there. The line is, it is the outlet temperature of intercooler is 40 degrees Celsius. It was given. Now this is the intercooler, process 2 to process 3 was the intercooler. So outlet temperature of intercooler means 0.3, T3 which is 40 degrees Celsius. So if we will add 273 here, so how much will we get? 313 K. This thing was also given. Right. Since it is a not perfect intercooling, so this formula we cannot apply. Then if we cannot apply this formula, then how to solve this question, I will tell. Right. So, first, what we have to do for stage one, we have to calculate power during first stage of compressor. So, A part we will calculate power during first stage of compressor. What do you mean by first stage of compressor? This is the first stage of compressor. So for this one, what is the work done formula? Or power input equal to work done equal to n by n minus 1 mr. Which temperature you have to take? You have to take the inlet temperature for the compressor. For stage 1, this 0.1 to 2, this is the compression process. So inlet temperature of this compression process is 0.1, means T1. So mr T1 whole into pressure ratio for first stage. The pressure ratio, this is the first stage. So for the first stage, the pressure ratio is P2 by P1. So it is P2 by P1 whole to the power n minus 1 by n. So by using this formula, power required to drive the compressor is brake power. Okay, the power required to drive the compressor is brake power. But here, Okay, this question is actually not the correct one. I have to change this question. Okay, actually here the question, actual question should be, what is the power which will be produced by the compressor? The question, actual question is, what is the power produced by the compressor? That was the actual question. Okay, because to calculate this brake power, we need mechanical efficiency, and mechanical efficiency was not given in the question. Okay, actually I forgot to change this line also. So it is actually, the first point is actually the power which will be produced by the compressor or work done by the compressor. So that we have to calculate here. So here simply we will put the formula. This is the first stage work done or first stage power, which is equal to N value is 1.3 divided by N minus 1, 1.3 minus 1 into mass flow rate of air. Mass flow rate of air is 0.1 kg per second, 0.1 into capital R value. So capital R value we will take 0.287 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. We will keep it in kilojoules only. So that this work done or power unit we will get in kilowatt. So R value is 0.287 into T1. T1 is how much? T1 is 300. Whole into P2 by P1, pressure ratio. So P2 was 350 kilopascal, P1 was 100 kilopascal. 350 kilopascal divided by 100 kilopascal whole to the power N minus 1 by N. So N is 1.3 minus 1 whole divided by 1.3 minus 1. So we solve it, how much answer we will get? 12.507 kilowatt. First work done, we will get 12.507 kilowatt. What is this W1 we have got? What is this 12.5 kilowatt? 12.5 kilowatt power will be produced during this first stage of compressor. Okay, so here we can produce 12.5 kilowatt of power. Now, yes, answer is 12.507, correct. Now, second thing is, we will calculate in the second stage, what will be the power produced. We will calculate in second stage, how much power will produce. So, part A completed, now we will go for part B. In part B, what we will calculate? We will calculate power or work done or power during second stage of compressor. During second stage of compressor, what is the power required? That we are going to calculate it now. 10.67, I think, okay. This is, I think, second stage work. So for this one, the formula we will write. So power required for the second stage is W2 equal to, same formula we will write, N by N minus 1 MR. Here, which temperature shall I write? Because we are taking the second stage compression. So for second stage, which is the compression process? 0.3 to 0.4. So we have to take the inlet temperature of the compressor, T3, correct? Okay. So for second stage, this is the compression process, 3 to 4. So which one is the inlet temperature during the compression? 0.3. So that's why the temperature becomes T3. Whole into, what is the pressure ratio? For second stage, the pressure, high pressure is P4, low pressure is P2. Okay. Second stage is from this point to this point. So for second stage, the high pressure is P4 and low pressure is P2. So we will write here P4 by P2 to the power N minus 1 by N minus. Then we will put the value over here. So N value is 1.3 divided by 1.3 minus 1 mass flow rate is 0.1 into universal gas constant, R value is 0.287 into T3 is how much? T3 we have taken 313. So T3 will be 313 whole into P4 by P2. What is P4? P4 is 1000 and P2 is 350. So 1000 by 350 whole to the power n minus 1 by n. So 1.3 minus 1 by 1.3. So if we solve this, how much answer we will get? 10.6711, right? So if we solve this, work done by the second stage of compressor will be 10.6711 kilowatts. Clear? So during first stage, this is the first stage. In first stage, how much work we got? 12.5 kilowatt. In second stage, how much work we got? We got 10.67 kilowatt. So total power required. Total power required, which is equal to total work done. Because work done we are taking with respect to mass flow rate is equal to W1 plus W2. Okay, so W1 we have 12.507 is 12.507 plus W2 is how much? W2 we got 10.6711. 10.67 double. Now you just add these two things, 23.178. 23.178 kilowatt. This is the answer. 23.178. Yes, correct. Right? So you just identify the difference between perfect intercooling and imperfect intercooling. If in the question paper here they will mention perfect intercooling, then directly work done equal to 2 times n by n minus 1, this formula you write and you will get the answer. But by chance, if in the question paper they will mention imperfect intercooling or the intercooling is not perfect, like they have asked here, means in that case what we have to do? Separately, we have to calculate the work done for the first stage and we have to calculate work done for the second stage by applying the FEM formula. We have calculated the work done during the first stage of compressor and we have calculated the work done during second stage of compressor. Then simply you add these two work done, you will get the total work done during the compressor process. Okay, so this is the difference between perfect intercooling and imperfect intercooling. Now the last part, second, so the first part we have completed. Okay. So now the second part is saving of work as compared to single stage compressor. So second part we will calculate. Saving of work as compared to single stage compressor. Single stage compressor. So this means, so what is this 23.178 for two stage compressor? This is the work done. We will calculate for single stage compressor what will be the work done. Then we will see what is the saving of work. Okay. So for single stage, compressor, okay, so total work done is equal to n by n minus 1 MR D1 high pressure divided by low pressure to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1. This is the formula. Okay. Single stage means this intermediate stage will not be there. Okay, so the directly air will enter from this point, and this compression will take place till point 4, and the air will expand. Okay, this intermediate stage will not be there. So the lowest pressure is P1, which is 100 kilopascal, and highest pressure is P4, which is 1000 kilopascal. Okay, so that's why I have written P high by P low. So simply we will put it quickly. You calculate how much we are getting here. N value is 1.3. 1.3 minus 1. So mass flow rate is how much? Mass flow rate is 0.1. So mass flow rate will put 0.1 over here into universal gas constant. R value is 0.287 into T1. Inlet temperature is how much? 300 Kelvin. Whole into high pressure is 1000. High pressure means P4. P4 is 1000. Low pressure is P1. P1 means 100 kilopascal. We will write it. High pressure is 1000 divided by low pressure is 100. Whole to the power n minus 1 by n. N is 1.3 is given. Minus 1 divided by 1.3 minus 1. If we solve this, what is the total work done we are getting for single stage compressor? We are getting 26.1637. Okay. We are getting 26.1637 kilowatts. Okay. So for single stage compressor, the work done is 26 kilowatt. For two stage compressor, the work done is 23 kilowatt. So what is the saving work? We can say. So how much work we can save during single stage compressor? So the saving work becomes 26.1637 minus, in second stage how much we are getting? 23.178. 23.178. How much we are getting? 2.985 kilowatt. Okay, so you got the meaning of the saving work. What do you mean by saving work? In single stage compressor, the work done we are getting is 26.16 kilowatt. In two stage compressor, how much work we have to input? We have to give 23 kilowatt. Okay, so what will be the saving of work in single stage as compared to single stage compressor? Saving of work is 26.1637 minus 23.178. So 2.9 kilowatt, approximately 3 kilowatt power we can save if we will go for two stage compressor. If you will go for three stage compressor, then you can save more than 3 kilowatt power. If you can go for four stage compressor, even you can be able to save more amount of power. Okay, so that is the advantage of multi-stage compressor as compared to single stage compressor. You can save the work and you can deliver high pressure ratio as compared to single stage compressor. Okay, so in this way we can solve this question, right? So once again, we will meet tomorrow. All these things that we have discussed today, I will put in the group. Once go through it, practice the problems. If you are getting doubts anywhere, feel free to ask. So that's all about for today. See you tomorrow. Have a nice day.